If you're living with diabetes, you might have heard of or might have been prescribed with metformin. This is because metformin is a medication that may help reduce insulin resistance, which is a common symptom in people with diabetes. But what does it have to do with Parkinson's disease, you might ask? In our last video, 5 important things you should know about metformin, some of you asked us if there is a link between using metformin and Parkinson's disease. Well, new studies have emerged exploring the link between metformin and Parkinson's, and we've found surprising data that we'd like to share with you. Today, we break it all down. So don't go anywhere and keep watching. In this video, we'll explore the data found on Parkinson's and metformin and answer your question. Is Parkinson's a side effect of metformin in diabetes patients? But before we get started, can you do us a favor and like this video, ring the bell for future notifications, and make sure to subscribe to the Diabetics Talk channel for more help managing diabetes. Plus, stick around to find out how you can get not one, not two, but 3 free gifts. And now, let's find out if Parkinson's disease can be a side effect of metformin by first answering, what is Parkinson's disease? Parkinson's disease is a progressive disorder that impacts the nervous system and, as a result, the body's movement. While common symptoms of Parkinson's comes in the form of tremors, muscle rigidity, physical imbalance, and impaired posture, Parkinson's is the result of nerve cells gradually breaking down and dying. As the brain and nervous system loses neurons, a chemical messenger is created, causing impairments. Research has observed that genetics, age, and exposure to toxins are some of the most common risk factors for Parkinson's disease. Additionally, trends have shown that men are more likely to develop it than women, as well as people with diabetes mellitus. Diabetes mellitus happens when someone with type 2 diabetes can't regulate both insulin and blood glucose levels. Someone with diabetes mellitus is likely to experience high levels of blood glucose regularly, strong insulin resistance, and overall inflammation over a long period of time. A review observed a link between diabetes mellitus and Parkinson's disease. After gathering data from 21 studies, experts pointed out that patients diagnosed with diabetes mellitus had an increased risk of Parkinson's compared to other diabetes. They also noted that patients diagnosed with Parkinson's disease and diabetes mellitus had greater severity in symptoms. So, what is the role of metformin in all of this? Well, let's find out by exploring what is metformin. Metformin is a medication for diabetics that primarily targets insulin. Insulin is a hormone created by the pancreas that helps regulate blood glucose. But when you're living with type 2 diabetes, your insulin might not work properly. This is known as insulin resistance. Insulin resistance can impact the body's good functioning and increase inflammation, high blood glucose levels, and diabetes complications when not managed. Metformin can help reduce insulin resistance to make type 2 diabetes more manageable and keep markers in a healthy range. Metformin can be prescribed to anyone with diabetes, and it is shown to be particularly beneficial for those with diabetes mellitus. A study found that people with diabetes mellitus who took metformin experienced improved HbA1c levels and blood glucose levels. However, metformin is known to also come with side effects. A study in 120 patients with type 2 diabetes observed that 51% of patients experienced inflammatory side effects after taking 1,000 milligrams of metformin. The side effects included nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and stomach pain. However, most patients had side effects only during the initial phase of the treatment. Yet, while these side effects don't seem too alarming, it has been found in a handful of cases that metformin can be far more damaging to someone's health. So the question we're here to answer is, does that include Parkinson's disease? Well, before we answer that, are you ready for a free gift? Discover an entire world of diabetes-fighting foods with our new book, 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar. Plus, you'll discover the real reason why type 2 diabetes, obesity, and heart disease are increasing at an alarming rate, and find out what really works when it comes to preventing these illnesses by watching our free one-hour documentary, The Scary Truth About Sugar. And not only that, we are giving away a free recipe book, Amazing Alternatives to Rice, Pasta, and Bread, which contains over 50 easy to prepare and easy to follow recipes you can eat with the whole family. These gifts are free and waiting for you to grab them in the description box below. And now let's get back to our question and look at the link between metformin and Parkinson's disease. We now know that Parkinson's disease involves dying nerve cells, and people with diabetes mellitus have a greater risk of developing Parkinson's. We also observed that metformin is a medication used to help symptoms of diabetes mellitus, and it can also have serious side effects. So, how does it all connect? Well, one important symptom of diabetes mellitus is chronic inflammation. Chronic inflammation plays an important role in the damage and loss of nerve cells. Studies have found that the chemicals secreted by the body to deal with chronic inflammation can lead to persistent neuron inflammation, which can cause Parkinson's. With all forms of diabetes, the medication metformin primarily focuses on insulin. And while some studies pointed out that the medicine can have anti-inflammatory effects, it has been shown that it also prohibits neurons from being protected against inflammation. A 2016 experiment on rats with diabetes mellitus found that metformin failed to protect neurons against inflammation and influenced an increased neuron death. And as a result, it also accelerated the onset and progression of Parkinson's disease. Another study observed similar results. After two groups of patients with diabetes mellitus took different doses of metformin, they also found that those with higher dosage had greater odds of developing Parkinson's disease. However, while not all people with type 2 diabetes and diabetes mellitus and taking metformin are at risk of having Parkinson's disease, the levels of inflammation and metformin dosage can play a significant role in the disease. But you must remember, these studies are still in their very early phases, and the further we dig into the subject matter, we also encounter studies showing that metformin may actually help fight Parkinson's disease. A study published in the Journal of BioX Research has shown that metformin has some neuroprotective effects. This means that taking metformin may actually help protect neurons, and as a result, help keep Parkinson's at bay. The same study acknowledged that there's a correlation between Parkinson's disease and diabetes, as patients with diabetes are more likely to develop Parkinson's disease. This is because both diseases have very similar pathogenesis. The study also cited that metformin has actually been shown to help promote nerve regeneration. It also has shown that there is a good chance that metformin and other anti-diabetic drugs may be used in the treatment of Parkinson's and other neurologic conditions. However, it does acknowledge that long-term metformin use has its side effects, and this includes putting the patient at risk for developing Alzheimer's disease, another neurodegenerative condition. Long-term metformin use is also associated with vascular dementia. And there you have it. Parkinson's and diabetes are correlated to some degree, and metformin may or may not help both conditions. But further studies need to be conducted before we can determine if you should stop taking metformin for your diabetes or not. Current studies are still in the preclinical stage, and it may be a while before definitive conclusion can be reached. and now we want to hear from you. Are you surprised about what you learned on Parkinson's and metformin? Are there any other topics you wish us to feature in this channel? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. And before you leave, make sure to claim your free gifts by clicking the link in the description below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell button for more Diabetics Talk. We want to keep making informative research-based videos for you. So if you got value from this video and would like more of it, you can send us a super thanks by clicking the thanks button at the bottom of the video. Thanks for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.